You know what? Today I was hoping to review the brand new Lego Ghostbusters Firehouse Headquarters playset, but it hasn't arrived yet. But I have a video quota I have to hit on a monthly basis, so let's eat some slightly aged cereal. Ghostbusters cereal. Does it hold up? No. Coming. Well, we've got our delivery here, and it is just so huge we can't even fit it in the frame. Seriously, I think this box is big enough I could probably just jump into it and pop out like a Pokemon. Alright, and a few cuts to the box, and we got it open. And yes, as we hoped and thought, inside we've got the Lego Ghostbusters Firehouse Headquarters. Now, this guy clocks in at a massive 4,634 pieces, and I'm kind of a Lego novice. So while I'm really excited about this thing, I'm also kind of scared half to death. Aside from this, the only builds I've done over the past 20 years has been the Ghostbusters Ecto-1, the Back to the Future DeLorean, and a bunch of those little Lego Dimensions action figures. So using the power of technology, let's skip ahead 17 hours and show you what this guy looks like 100% completed. And just like that, the Lego Ghostbusters Firehouse is completed. And the first thing I have to say, yes, it was in fact a 17-hour build for me, but it was actually pretty easy. Novices don't feel challenged by this. It's an extremely fun build and actually moves along quite quickly too. Now before we dive deep within the firehouse, let's talk about the figures it comes with. We've got Ray Stantz, Egon Spengler, Peter Venkman, and of course, Winston Zeddemore. All four characters do look pretty similar to what we saw with the Ecto-1 Lego set, but there are some slight changes. Arms now feature elbow pads, as well as also the No Ghosts logo and a pocket on the left side. Venkman and Zeddemore also feature brand new hair sculpts, and Peter features a slimed torso, as well as also an optional slimed face. Certainly my most favorite figure in the entire set. We also have Dana Barrett and Lewis Tully, and Lewis does come with two different faces and hair pieces. One's kind of the messy design, the other one is a colander in case you want to do some lab work on him up in Egon's lab that's inside the firehouse. The Ghostbusters receptionist, Janine, also makes an appearance, who looks tremendously like Annie Potts from the first film. I mean, they did an awesome job on the face. And what would be the Ghostbusters without some ghosts to bust? We get the taxi cab driver ghost, also Eleanor Twitty, the Gray Lady, the library ghost, whatever you want to call her. And she also does feature a replaceable hair and a separate face that you can use, you know, in case somebody wants to get her. Everybody's favorite slime ball, Slimer, makes an appearance, who's holding a massive Vienna-looking sausage. We also get a couple filler ghosts, being the pink and the blue translucent ghosts. Now let's talk about the exterior of the firehouse. It has that great gray and red brick-looking design to it. The No Ghosts logo is present right above the door like is seen in the first film. And the doors also do open, so for those who want to actually put the Ecto-1 kind of inside the firehouse, you can do that. Yes, the Ecto-1 does not fit inside of there properly unless you do some slight modifications like getting rid of Janine's desk, but we'll get to that. You also have a traffic light on the outside, as well as also a garbage can. And on the one side, much like the instructions have suggested, we've displayed the three ghosts, Slimer, the pink, and the blue ghost, on these little clear pegs here. It kind of looks like the ghosts are just kind of flying around the firehouse and the Ghostbusters aren't really doing their job. And we also have to note that if you take a look a little further down there, you're going to see some of the river of slime creeping up through the Lego cracks. As a Vigo lover, so awesome. And on the other side, you're going to find this awesome ladder structure, as well as also a door right in the middle area there that will lead you inside the firehouse. Now, speaking of inside the firehouse, let's go ahead and crack this guy open. And here it is in all of its glory. I mean, how can you not be impressed by this set? You've got three full floors, four if you want to count that containment unit basement over here, and so many awesome cool builds inside of here. Now, as I mentioned initially, the Ecto-1 does not fit fully inside. That is, unless you want to get rid of some of the stuff that's here on the floor, like the newspapers, the cardboard boxes, and Janine's desk. Now, I don't know why you want to do that, because all those things look awesome, and I kind of like the look of the Ecto-1 kind of barreling right through the front of the firehouse. Behind Janine's desk, we've got Dr. Peter Venkman's office, which I've got Venkman sitting back there as well. And behind that, we have the basement, which is where they put the Ecto containment unit. Yes, we've got the red light, we've got the green light, and the containment unit does open and close, so you can put the ghost traps inside. Also, on the other side here, you're going to see the locker area, which we have a locker for Egon Spengler, Race Stans, and Peter Venkman. Sorry, Winston, you don't have the locker. Think of it like the first film. It's okay. You can take the stairs up to the second floor, which you're going to find their eatery area, which some would call a kitchen. You have some mood slime on the table, along with that toaster from the second film. And I also really love the cupboard detail that includes the cereals here. We also have a refrigerator and a freezer that has a pizza inside. Also had a super fun time building this Ghostbusters arcade machine that features the likeness of Stay Puft of the Marshmallow Man on the screen. Continuing on, you're going to see the sleeping quarters, which, once again, three beds. Sorry, Winston. And jumping over here was one of my most favorite rooms to actually build. It is the bathroom. I love the white and black checkered tile flooring. Also the detail when it comes to the sink, the toilet, and the shower. I love how the toilet also has slime just barreling from it, as if maybe Slimer just had to evacuate his bowels in a post-haste rush. And then going up another flight of stairs, you're gonna find Egon's laboratory. And this is where you can do all those crazy science experiments and studies on Lewis Tully. Really love the look and design of all the gadgetry and everything that's in the back. From there, we also have the billiards table, which does come with pool cues and really everything you'd want to need to play Lego billiards. And I also must say, once again, that billiards table, super fun to put together. And jumping over here, we have the dark room, which features Viggo the Carpathian photos all up on the wall, and yes, they're on fire, much like we've seen in the second film. And of course, on the other side of that door, we've got a little area with a fire extinguisher, so you know, Winston can kind of break through the door and save the day. I mean, I guess he doesn't get a locker, he doesn't get a bed, but hey, he can still save the day, so that's something, right? And after the fire extinguisher, you're gonna see the top of the pole. And of course, what happens? Well, you gotta try this pole. And that about does it for our look at the LEGO Ghostbusters Firehouse Headquarters. We'd like to thank LEGO for making this review possible. We hope all you guys check us out again right here next time on GhostbustersNews.com. Definitely stuck.